Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for the latest updated videos.
Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel Query Solution. So children, in the previous video we had talked about monohybrid cross. This will be a very short video because in this video I'll be discussing about the two laws that Mendel has proposed based on the monohybrid cross, which is law of dominance and law of segregation. So even if you want to know this into detail, do watch my video completely. And for now, let us start up with the video. I hope now you can you will be at least able to draw any monohybrid cross given to you. And as I said, you, this is just one example of plant height that we had taken, but any character can be given to you to draw a cross, and in the same manner you should write. And again, I will say, you, the marks always goes at stepwise, so do not avoid any step which is there, because again you have to get marks based on the steps individually. So when Mendel was performing his monohybrid cross, taking one character into consideration, as you can see over here in the cross itself, he actually has deduced certain inferences based on these crosses that he has performed, because for all the seven characters you were getting the same type of result. So as you can see in this example which is being quoted, which is on plant height, when a cross was made between a tall and a dwarf plant in the F1 generation, the plants that expressed the character were all that were tall. As you can see, all the plants, as many plants that he got, all the plants were tall in this condition. So based on this, he saw that tall is the character that is being expressed, and the recessive one, which is dwarf, is not getting expressed in the F1. Based on this, he proposed a law. What's the law? The law is the law of dominance. Now, as I think you can be able to relate with the term which is being mentioned, dominance. Dominance means when there is a fusion which is made between a dominating and a recessive characteristic, only the dominating one is able to express itself in the next generation. So that's what is being mentioned in the law of dominance, that when a cross will be made between two different varieties of trait, the trait which will be dominating will be able to express itself, and the one which is recessive will not express itself. But yes, eventually it will be expressed in the F2 generation, but not in the F1. So that was all about the law of dominance, that the dominating will express, recessive will not express, or it will get suppressed in the presence of dominating. The second one is the law of segregation. Now, segregation can be a new term to you, but I'll just quote a simple term. Segregation, you can also understand with the term separation. So in this manner, when we are looking at this cross over here, you can see that these alleles which are there, they are actually segregating or separating. Like out of these two, anyone is coming. Out of these two, anyone is coming, and then out of the two alleles which are there, only one is getting inherited into the next generation. That's the simple concept of law of segregation. Segregation means whenever there is a cross being performed, or whenever there is inheritance of gene that occur, only these alleles which are there, they segregate, they separate, and one of them is inherited into the next generation. That's what is law of segregation. So I hope you are clear with the law. Again, I said you, it was just a very simple video. And in the next video, we will be dealing up with the dihybrid cross and with the law of independent assortment. So do follow my video, and if you have liked the video, do not forget to put down a like button, and please do subscribe my channel. Thank you.